Hi everyone, I'm Jess. I make videos about science, engineering, and conservation. And if you click this video today thinking that I'm just gonna bash everyone in the zero waste, plastic-free living movement, then you are severely mistaken. Sorry about that. But before we start this video, I do want to say thank you to Dev Mountain for sponsoring this video. If you don't know Dev Mountain, they are a coding school that teach web development, iOS development, UX design, and they offer free housing to all of their students. So make sure to check out Dev Mountain if you are about to start your coding journey. Thank you to Dev Mountain for sponsoring this video. What I did want to do today, though, was I do want to talk about plastic, and I want to sort of argue against the plastic-free movement and explain why I think this isn't actually the best way to go about protecting our planet and offer an alternative solution, maybe. So what I wanted to do was kind of go through the most popular arguments against plastic, and then at the end offer my own solution, which is not really a solution. But in all of this, guys, I just want to say that when I was researching this video, you know, anything that has to do with life cycle assessment is super complicated because you have to, you know, consider raw extracted materials. So for example, in the case of plastic, that's refining oil, and oil is a non-renewable resource. So you have raw material extraction, then you have recycled material, and then all of the energy that goes into recycling or extracting, where is that power coming from? Is it also from renewables? Is it from non-renewables? So it's just, it's really complicated. Then, you know, plastic is packaged and shipped and there's transportation costs. I'm not gonna get all into it. I'm just gonna give, I tried to kind of combine everything into a very concise way to explain it to you. So here it goes. So the first argument against plastic that I see a lot is like, there's tons of plastic in our oceans. You know, you get all of these like little Facebook videos that are like, look at this giant Pacific Ocean garbage patch. There's a giant plastic island the size of China or whatever floating around in the ocean. I wanna challenge you to look at what happens in your own country. So for example, I live here in Switzerland, and here we have infrastructure. We have an entire system that goes into, you know, separating aluminum, dark glass, light glass, plastic, compost, and trash. And we have entire infrastructure, all of that is separated, and then anything that can't be recycled is incinerated. I'm not saying that this is the best solution in the world. I'm just saying that I know what happens to, at least I think I know, what happens to our trash here in Switzerland. It's collected, it's incinerated, there is a bit of electricity that's produced from heat, of combustion, and then the exhaust gas, the flue gas, is scrubbed and cleaned as much as possible and then released into the atmosphere. So at least here in Switzerland, we're not a coastal country, we don't have direct access to the ocean, only via rivers. So our plastic doesn't directly end up into the ocean. I'm not saying that this is the solution that everyone should follow. I'm just saying here that the trash you see in the oceans might not necessarily be your trash. So all of the effort, because I used to be one of these like zero waste plastic free people, all of the effort and money I was putting into like looking for products that were packaged in like cardboard or plastic or glass, for example, maybe my energy could be more useful in another area. I just think that my effort into living plastic free wouldn't have an effect because we're not a coastal region. For example, I was just in Romania and in Indonesia, and there is so much trash on the side of the road, which then after rainfall slides into the river, river carries it off. The people are like, well, that's it. That's what we do. We throw the trash in the river and the river takes it away. That's how we get rid of our trash because they have no infrastructure. The trash, it's windy. The trash then gets transported by rivers into the ocean. It's the same thing when I was in Indonesia just now. In Indonesia, you have tons of trash on the side of the roads, on the side of the rivers. river transports the trash into the ocean. We went snorkeling. There was tons of trash in the ocean. The difference is that we have infrastructure here in Switzerland, and countries like Romania and Indonesia don't have infrastructure. The people don't know what to do with their trash. I'm gonna have all of these resources linked below in the description. For example, one study found that out of 192 coastal countries, 20 of these countries were responsible for 82% of the ocean's plastic. And in these top 20 countries, you have China, you have Indonesia, you have the Philippines, and then in slot number 20, you have the US. So I would argue that we shouldn't eliminate plastic because we have an infrastructure problem. Because even if we eliminate plastic, we're still going to be sending tons of clothes and other crap into the ocean. The second argument that is heard very often is plastic takes 10 to thousands of years to degrade. Again, I don't like this argument because why would we want plastic to degrade? Why are we throwing it on the ground in the first place? Maybe you're thinking about in landfills. Plastic takes a long time to degrade in landfills. Well, then I would say that you actually don't understand how landfills work, because landfills aren't meant to have anything decompose. Landfills are actually created in a way, they're super low oxygen and low light environments that are created in a way for trash to be mummified. So many landfills have actually started to limit the amount of biodegradable material that comes into their landfill. The whole point of the landfill is that the trash doesn't emit greenhouse gases when it decomposes, and it doesn't seep toxins into the ground. It's meant to be mummified. And plus, many studies have even found that paper bags do not degrade any faster than plastic bags in a landfill. So if you think you're doing everyone a favor by buying a paper bag and then throwing it out, it's just the exact same as a plastic bag. And I guess you could argue that maybe, yeah, like plastic floating around gets stuck in a tree, it's a lot uglier than like a paper bag that fell on the ground and got mushed up in the rain and got covered in mud. You can't see it, so I guess you can't see that it actually emits more CO2 than a thin plastic bag does. But you can see the plastic bags, so that's why we should eliminate plastic and move towards paper. The third argument that I've been seeing a lot is that plastic bags are hard to recycle. Well, it's actually not more difficult to recycle plastic than it is to recycle paper. And it takes 91% less energy to recycle a pound of plastic than it does to recycle a pound of paper. But yes, at the end of its life cycle, plastic is more difficult to recycle. But again, I think we should be maybe investing in like a different type of infrastructure, like more efficient incineration units instead of just dumping them into landfills. I'm not gonna go through every single argument. I'll just quickly go over some of the more popular ones that you hear often. So another argument is like, oh, they're harmful to marine and wildlife and also to human beings. But again, I think this is an infrastructure problem. If we didn't have plastic, we would be polluting the earth with other crap like textiles. Oh wait, we already do that. When I was in Romania, all you could see along the banks of the river was clothes and clothes and clothes. It's dumped on the floor, falls into the river, river rises, gets caught in the trees. All of the trees along the river are covered in clothes. So if it's not plastic, you're gonna be polluting the earth with other ways. And then another argument is plastic is made from non-renewables. Yeah, okay, fossil fuels are non-renewable because they take billions of years to generate. But at the same time, the paper industry accounts for 10% of the world's deforestation, and deforestation accounts for 12% of the world's greenhouse gas emissions. And trees are renewable, but they also take a while to grow. And illegal deforestation is a big problem in the world, so I don't think just switching from plastic to paper is gonna solve the world's problems. And now I'm just gonna read a bunch of facts about paper versus plastic, and you can find all of the tons of resources, papers, linked below in the description. You also need to consider that making paper bags consumes 4 times as much energy and 3 times the amount of water than making plastic bags. And of course, you have to think about, where does that energy come from? Is that energy renewable energy, or is that energy non-renewable energy? Maybe making paper bags is also coming from a non-renewable resource. Additionally, making paper bags generates 80% more solid waste, generates 70% more air pollution, and creates 50 times more water pollution. Plastic also has many benefits. So for example, you go to the grocery store, and I know it's annoying to see all of these like individually wrapped broccolis, but if you consider the fact that all of your food is being shipped from one region, like in a shipping container or on an airplane, this is how we figured out how to solve like the world's food problem. Like once we wrap the broccolis individually, you know, you won't have one bad apple spoiling the rest. So it's the solution that we've come up with so far to protect the food that is traveling long distances. I'm not saying it's the best solution, I'm just saying we need to consider the fact that, you know, if we're not going to wrap these peppers individually, then we need to consider the fact that maybe, you know, 20% of the peppers are going to go bad during transport, so we need to create X amount more acres of cropland to make up for those peppers that will die during transport. So then we have to cut down this many more trees to create this extra cropland and use this much more water to feed this crop. So I'm just saying that so far this is the best solution that engineers have come up with. Don't know if it's the best, just saying it's what we have so far. Another solution is like plastic straws, for example. So plastic straws help old people and disabled people drink and eat because the straws are bendy and they also don't conduct heat, so that's a plus for straws. And then additionally, you have like food that's already cut up and pre-packaged, like right when you enter the grocery store. And at first you're thinking like, why would I want an apple that's sliced up and then packaged in plastic? That doesn't make any sense. I could just have an apple from the bin. But these foods give autonomy to disabled and elderly people that would otherwise need to be put in a home and fed. And this way they can just go into the grocery store and grab what they need and feed themselves. So I just want to conclude, don't feel overwhelmed and depressed with this video. I am not personally for or against plastic. I'm just against misinformation by companies that are trying to greenwash everything and brainwash you basically into thinking that by purchasing everything wrapped in paper, you're actually saving the planet instead of purchasing something wrapped in plastic. I think the best solution for everyone is to, before you purchase something, just think about if you need it. I think consumerism is really the problem here. Infrastructure is also a big problem. If you're just avoiding plastic like the plague, but still consuming tons and tons of paper products, then you're not actually helping the environment. Another article that I'll link below, many articles have actually found that if you use a paper bag instead of a plastic bag, you have to use that paper bag at least 3 times before it has the same environmental impact as a plastic bag. And then if you use the plastic bag as a garbage liner, then you have to use the paper bag 6 times before it has the same environmental impact as a plastic bag. But then you have to consider the fact that, you know, paper bags, they're not as sturdy as the plastic bag, so are you really gonna get 6 uses out of a paper bag instead of a plastic bag? Thanks so much for watching. Please just consider this video the next time you see a company trying to greenwash their product and trying to convince you to consume their product when it's something that you don't actually need. Consider next time at the grocery store, if you need a bag, how many times will you use it before you throw it away? Paper recycling industry uses a lot more energy and water to recycle their products as opposed to the plastic recycling industry. So just consider that next time. And yeah, just be kind to each other in the comments and let me know what you think about this and if you also fell for the media's tricks and for greenwashing campaigns by companies. Thanks for watching.